We have seen a glimpse of fully associative caches, so now let's go from the other direction, which is let's first look at direct map caches. If this is the memory and it contains blocks 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. And these are the block numbers, not the addresses, so I'm assuming that this thing here is an entire block worth of memory, which contains multiple locations. And let's say we have a cache with room for 4 blocks. We can number the lines 0, 1, 2, and 3. And in a direct map cache, block 0, if it's in the cache at all, needs to be in line number 0. Block 1, if it's in the cache at all, will be in slot number 1. Block number 2, if it is in the cache at all, has to be in this place here. Block number 3, if it is in the cache at all, has to be here. And now block number 4 will again get to map to line number 0. Block number 5 maps to line number 1. Block number 6 maps to line number 2, etc. So pretty much for any given block address, there is only one place in the cache where that address can be. If we look at a memory address, the least significant bits are still the block offset. They tell us where in the block are we, assuming that we find the block. The block number now contains some bits that tell us where in the cache this block can be. The index bits need to be sufficient to tell us which of the lines in the cache are we talking about. So if there are 4 lines in the cache, then we need 2 index bits to tell us where a block can map. And that is why in the block number it was 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. It was determined by the lowermost bits of the block number. And the remaining bits of the address are now the tag. Now there is an interesting question of why the tag does not include the full block number. So why doesn't the tag cover also the index bits? And the answer to this is that the tag needs to tell us which of the blocks do we have in this place. And the answer is that the tag needs to identify which block we have in the cache. Considering that the block with some index bits has to be in one place in the cache, the tag for that place in the cache doesn't need to tell us what the index bits are. By looking at this particular line, we have already determined that these index bits have to be the ones that correspond to that line. So all we have to do is tell us which of the lines that can possibly be here do we really have. And for that, we only need these bits, because the index bits are pretty much predetermined once we are already looking here. In other words, if we stored the index bits in the tag, all of the tags that we could possibly put here would have the same index bits, which means we don't have to store them because we already know them.